Well, it's time to go to our chat room for some questions, and so we bring it online.
Okay, this is a question from one of our viewers who say, what are your thoughts on adoption? I was told by a coworker who used to be a pastor that that adoption is not right with the Bible and God. Why would he say that?
Well, there's a reason he used to be a pastor if he's saying that. Good grief. It's plain as day in James. Taking care of widows and orphans is pure and undefiled religion. We all have the spirit of adoption. That's why we get to say Abba, Father. You know, God's in the adoption business. He wants to adopt all of us. He wants to graft us into the kingdom. Those who are far off, who are estranged, he wants to give us a family. He wants to put children into families. He even says, when your mother and father abandon you, I will raise you up. So don't listen to him.
Wise counsel.
Well, how do you feel? Yeah.
Well, I mean, I think it's so obvious that we are all adopted. I mean, just look up the word adopt, adoption, adopted. I mean, it's throughout the Bible. It's very clear. Yeah. Jacob says, my neighbor does not discipline her 5-year-old son. She lets him cuss, use knives, jump fences, and didn't even yell at him when he was sitting in the middle of the road. I want to tell her to raise her kid better, but the Bible says we should love our neighbors. I'm not sure what to do here.
Well, you can speak the truth in love. I mean, if she's actually telling the child to go play in the street, you're setting up for a big accident. Any 5-year-old shouldn't be playing around with knives. Again, you're setting yourself up for an accident. So speaking the truth in love is fine, and that can be part of loving your neighbor. Just to say, do you think it's really a good idea? Don't you understand the danger here? And I think it can be protection for both the 5-year-old and for your neighbor.
Mm-hmm. This is Kidra, who says, my 17-year-old daughter has been abusive towards me. Recently, she took my car when I told her she couldn't go out for the evening. So I called the police on her and told them that she stole my car. Am I wrong for getting the cops involved? I've tried everything. What else can I do?
I'll speak as a lawyer. As a lawyer, I'm just not in favor of police getting involved in this kind of thing unless somebody's physically in danger. You've given permission for your daughter to have the car before, and so to now say she stole it, you can create a criminal record for your child that will be with them for the rest of their life. I just don't think that's the proper way. 17-year-olds, for whatever reason, are trying to form their own identity. They're trying to do things on their own. It's a notoriously rebellious time. I pray for any parent of teenage children just comfort you with these words, this too shall pass. And at some point in their 20s and maybe as late as their 30s, they'll come to understand that maybe mom was right all along.
This is Tawashia, who says, I believe in God and pray to him every day, but I do not go to church. I've tried, but none of the churches I've attended seem to fit me. Meanwhile, I feel that God never answers my prayers. I'm worried that it's because I don't go to church. Should I just suck it up and find one?
God is answering your prayers. There's no brownie point system with God. You don't earn merit badge points by going to church. I encourage people to go to church, and the Bible encourages people to go to church. Don't forsake the fellowship. If you're looking for the perfect church, if you find it, then you'll show up, and it won't be perfect anymore. It's very elusive to say, I'm looking for the perfect church that's just the fit for me. It's not going to happen. Just find fellowship of believers. Find a church that's preaching the gospel. Find a church that's loving, and you'll be right at home. And before you know it, you'll be forming a whole community. And one of the wonderful things about churches is it is community, and they can be a help when you need, and you can help others when they need. And it's a great place to do that. It's a great place to grow as a disciple. So I encourage people to go to church. And it's a wonderful thing. Churches were created by God. Jesus built the church. So go to it.